ஆண்டாள் திருவடிகளே சரணம். திருப்பாவை தேர்ட் பாசுரம். ஓங்கி உலகளந்த உத்தமன் பேர் பாடி, நாங்கள் நம்பாவைக்கு சாற்றி நீராடினால் தீங்கின்றி நாடெல்லாம் திங்கள் மும்மாறி பெய்து. ஓங்கு பெரும் சென்னல் உடுகயலுகள பூங்குவளை போதில் பொறிவண்டு கண்படுப்ப, தேங்காதே புக்கிருந்து சீர்த்த முளை பற்றி வாங்க குடம் நிறைக்கும் வள்ளல் பெரும் பசுக்கள் நீங்காத செல்வம் நிறைந்தேலோரெம்பாவாய். ஆண்டாள் கால்ட் ஆல் ஹர் ஃப்ரெண்ட்ஸ் டு பெர்ஃபார்ம் த பாவை நோம்பு, அண்ட் ஷி டோல்ட் அபவுட் ஹூம் த பாவை நோம்பு இஸ் இன் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் பாசுரம், அண்ட் வென்ட் அஹெட் டு டெல் அபவுட் த டூஸ் அண்ட் த டோன்ட்ஸ் ஆஃப் த பாவை நோம்பு இன் ஹர் செகண்ட் பாசுரம். நவ் இன் த தேர்ட் பாசுரம் ஷி டெல்ஸ் her friends that this pavai nombu is not only going to yield us with what we want, but it is also going to yield fruits to this place, to the people residing in this place, to the society. How is that, and what kind of benefit is the society going to get because of this? Andal says we are doing this pavai nombu by singing his glory. So incidentally, all goodness will come down to anybody who listens to his glory. Here, in the third pasuram, Andal is talking about singing the glory of the Lord's name. Uttaman per paadi. Per paadi refers to singing his glorious names. Now, we are seeing that Andal is talking about singing the glory of the Lord himself in the first pasuram. She is talking about singing the glory of the Lord's holy feet in the second pasuram. And now in the third pasuram, she is talking about singing the glory of his holy name. Now these three aspects are important in the ascending order. In the sense, the Lord is important, undoubtedly. But more important than that are his holy feet. And even more important is his holy name. The Purvacharyas say that the Lord is like a bar of gold and his name is like an ornament. If we want to enjoy something precious like gold, we make an ornament out of it and wear. So something which is more enjoyable is the Lord's name. It's even more enjoyable than himself. Kattipon pol avan, panipon pol avan tirunamam, say the Purvacharyas. The Lord is just like a bar of gold. He is useful. He can be used at the time of crisis. But if you want to enjoy him, you chant his names. That is like wearing an ornament of gold. So Andal says, by singing the glory of his names, we are starting our vrata. So it is sure to yield us fruits. And we are singing the glory of whom? Ongi ulagaLandha uttaman per paadi. We are singing the glorious names of that uttama, that highest one. Which highest one? The one who measured the worlds the other day. Ongi ulagaLandha. He took his feet high to measure the worlds that day when he came down as Trivikrama. Thus, let us sing his holy names, she's saying. Now, why is Andal talking about the Trivikramavatara in particular here? It is said that whenever we begin anything new, anything good, then we want to ensure that no obstacles come in between. And the best way to avoid obstacles is to think about Trivikramavatara. So she's hailing Lord Trivikrama here as Ongi ulagaLandha uttaman. Per paadi, we are starting our vrata by singing the glorious names of that Uttama who measured the worlds the other day. By resorting to this Uttama, Namum nam paavaikku saatri neeraadinaal. If we, Namum nam paavaikku, for our vrata, go and seek him, saatri neeraadinaal. What all will this world get out of that? What all will everybody get out of that? Thinginri nadellam thingal mummari peidu. This entire world will be blessed with sumptuousness. And sumptuousness and richness comes from good harvest. And for a good harvest, we need good rains. So the first thing that this vrata will bring in is good rains. And how will these rains be? She's specifying, Thinginri Nadellam. These rains will be showering throughout. Nadellam. It's not that one part of the country will be in drought and the other will be having rains. It will be there everywhere. Nadellam. At the same time, it will not be to the amount that it will cause havoc. It may cause floods. Such things will not happen. Thinginri Nadellam. No kind of unauspiciousness or evil can come because of these rains. Meaning, there is no danger of any flood. Thinginri Nadellam. Thingal Mummari Peidu. These rains will also come at the ordained time. It's very important that it rains only when it is expected to rain. That is in the rainy season. Because whatever crops are sown according to expectation of rain or no rain. So, if we have paddy being sown, then we want rains to come. Whereas, if we have some other millet which is being sown, then we do not want rains at that time. So, millets get sown at a time when not much rains are expected. So, the expected amount of rain at the expected time is also important. So, she is saying, Thingal Mummari Peidu, these rains will come at the scheduled time. And if it rains at all places at the scheduled time in the right amount, then what happens? Ongu Perum Sennal Oodu Kayalugala. You get crops which are really healthy. Because the soil has become fertile and there's abundant rain. And so you get what is called as Ongu Perum Sennal. Sennal refers to crops. And Ongu means tall. And Perum means stout. So you really get healthy crops. Tall and stout crops. Ongu Perum Sennal Oodu Kayalugala. Now when crops are such big and stout and there is abundant rain, it so happens that in between two plants in a crop, there is some water stagnated and that forms a small pool kind of a thing, and you have fish which are very beautifully playing in that little pool like water. Oodu kayalugala, kayal refers to a type of fish. So Andal is trying to very beautifully picturize in front of us that lush green scenery of a fertile land. Her poetic imagination takes her ahead to describe something even more beautiful. She says that amongst these crops, you also find some flowering plants. And these flowering plants have very beautifully blossomed flowers. And these flowers are rich in nectar. Bees come down to these flowers to drink this nectar. And after drinking, they are very happily sleeping away to glory. Poonkuvalai podil. Poonkuvalai refers to a kind of water blooming lily. Podu is flower. And inside that, porivandu kanpadupa. You have golden beetles which are intoxicated with honey and are actually sleeping happily. Thus, Andal has spoken about a beautiful green revolution that will happen because of their Pavai Nombu. Next, she goes ahead to describe white revolution because of the Pavai Nombu. She says, you know how cattle will be because of our Pavai Nombu? Tengade pukkirindu seertha mulai patri vaanga kudam niraikum vallal perum pasukkal. Pasukkal, cattle, will become perum pasukkal. Meaning they'll become stout, healthy cattle. And they'll also be vallal perum pasukkal. Meaning very generous stout cattle. They will generously produce milk. How generously will they produce? Vanga kudam niraikum. If you start milching them, the moment you put a vessel down, it will get full and overflow. Like that, there'll be abundance of milk. And to get this milk from the cow, you really don't have to struggle. Thengade pukkirundu seertha mulai patri vaanga. You can actually very easily go and milch the cows. The cows which do not provide any kind of resistance to milking them. They actually want to give all the milk they have. That kind of generous, abundant mentality these cows have. So, this will be the mentality of the cows because there is so much of abundance that they have with them. So, such a white revolution and green revolution would be possible if we do this Pavai Dombu. And because of such abundant prosperity, everybody will be happy. Now, it's not necessary that prosperity makes one happy. Abundance makes one happy. What is most important is satisfaction. We need to be satisfied that what we have is enough for us. And that is the best kind of happiness. So, this mentality of satisfaction will also come to people as a result of our vrata. Niraindu, she says. Niraindu refers to satisfaction, the satisfied mentality. So, all such prosperity will come down to our village, to this world, because of us performing this Pavai Nombu. Andal declares in front of her friends, and her friends are really impressed with this. But one of the friends is now having a doubt, which she will ask tomorrow.